Hello, good morning all. Today in this video we are going to discuss about how to create a new custom module in Odoo version 12. So in the screen you are seeing Odoo version 12 community edition. If I go to the settings, you can see this is Odoo version 12 community edition, which is already configured with PyCharm. So this is my custom addons path, which is already specified in the conf file. If you are not aware of how to add new custom addons path in Odoo, you can check our previous video in our YouTube channel and see how can you add new custom addons path. So we will add new module under this custom addons path. So I will go to the backend where it's, so this is my custom addons path, custom. In the custom addons path, there is, you can see already there is some few custom modules we have developed. So this is one of the custom module for accounting PDF reports. So the module and the module files will be placed inside a folder. So first of all, we have to create a folder. So let's start with an example of a hospital management software. Like we can record the patient details, doctor's details, patient visit, treatment details, etc. So once you give the name for the module, you have to give a appropriate name which suits with the subject. Like if I'm going to create a hospital management module, I cannot give name like students little park or theater management like that. So give the name with stands with the subject. So I will give a name like OM hospital. Hospital OM is for Odoo made, so that I can understand our modules. You can see OM underscore account accountant like that. So once seeing this name itself, we can understand that this is the module which depends or which is related with a hospital software. So if you see this module, you can see accounting PDF report. Yes, it might be the function adding functionalities like accounting PDF reports. So we have created a folder. In every Odoo module, you can see a common file. If you go to here, you open this module, you can see a manifest file. And if you open inventory dashboard module, you can see a manifest file. So manifest file will be a necessary file in each and every module. So I'll create a manifest file. So for that, it is a Python file you have to create. You have to put two underscore first, then manifest, then followed by two underscore again dot py Python file. So you have created the manifest file. If I comes to the front end, you have to keep the naming convention correctly, because two underscore has to be put first, then manifest, then again two underscore dot py file. So right now let's look how can we write things inside this manifest file. So rather than writing from each, I will copy an existing manifest file from an existing module. So I will copy it from here, Control C, and I will paste it inside our module, Control V. So I have copied the file, and let me remove the unnecessary lines now. Okay, it's done. So we have to start with the from here. So name for the module. So as we are going to create hospital management system, I'll give the name as hospital management. Hospital management. So this is the name for our module, hospital management. Then the version, as we are developing the module in Odoo version 12, this 12.0 is specified, that is version of Odoo. Then followed by the version. Suppose right now we have released this module as the with version 12.0.1.00. Later, after 2 months or 3 months, if there is some bug fixes or we have added new features to the module, we have to track the versions. Like version 12.0 has this 12 version, next version has these features like that. We have to specify each version. For that, later if we make some changes, we can put it like this: 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, etc. Right now it will be 0.0. Then comes to the category. Different categories are available. If I make a search of it, Control Shift F, you can see different available categories like project, extra tools, human resource, localization, warehouse, sales, etc. So if I'm going to create a module which stands or which extends the feature of sales module, I can give the category as sales. But by default, there is no category available in Odoo for hospital management, so I will go with extra tools, as it is an extra tool. Control C, and I will paste it here, category as extra tools. In the summary section, you can give a brief summary of your module. So I'll give summary as module for managing the hospitals. So I have given the summary as module for managing the hospital, and then comes to the sequence. Sequence is for, if you go to the apps menu, you can see that these modules are arranged in an order. So this order is based on the given sequence. Lower the sequence, the module will get listed at the first. So that is the use of the sequence. In the author section, you can place your name as you are the author of the module. If suppose if two, you and one of your colleague is developing your module, you can place your both names by putting the comma, like ABCD comma DEF, like that you can place the names. In the maintainer tab also, you can give the author's name itself. In the website, if you have a website, you can specify it. Then depends is used. Suppose if you are developing a module by extending sales module, in the depends you have to specify sales. If you are creating a module by extending accounting module, in the depends you have to specify account. So that's the use of the depends. In the demo section, suppose if you are, once you developed all the features of the hospital management things, for the demo purpose you have to add some demo files like patient records, disease records, doctor records, etc. For that the demo files are used. In the data files, you have to specify all the XML files you are defining in your module. So that's the use of the data file. Once you specify installable equal to true, the install button will get visible for the modules. And application equal to false here, I will make it application equal to true, so that the module will get displayed inside this apps filter. Right now there is only 51 modules. If I remove the apps filter, you can see 331 modules. In the app filter, the module for which the application equal to true is set will be get visible. So this is how we can create a manifest file. Now if I search the module inside the apps menu, if I make search hospital, the module won't get visible here. So once you develop a module, after placing, you have to restart the service. So I will restart my service. Yes, the service is restarted. Now comes to the front end, activate the developer mode. Okay, the developer mode, you can activate from here, activate the developer mode. So after activating developer, go to apps menu. From the apps menu, you can click update app list button, click update button. Now make search of hospital here. Hospital, you can either make search with the name given here or by this folder name, that is OM hospital. OM hospital, you will get the module. So I will open the module info. So this is the name hospital management which we have given here in the manifest file. Regarding version number, you can see here, you can see the version number here. The technical name will be the name of the folder, that is name of the module, that is this is will be the technical name of the module, OM hospital. This technical name, you can see website category summary which we have given in the manifest file. Regarding the license, by default, if you haven't specified any license in the manifest file, the license will be taken as LGPL version 3. Suppose if I am developing a module in AGPL version, you can specify the license in the manifest file itself. For that, license, and if my license is AGPL 3, I can specify it in the manifest. As I have made the changes in the Python, restart the service. Okay, service is restarted. Click the update app list button. Click the update app list button. It's done. Then reload the screen. You can see that license get updated to Affero GPL3. It was earlier, it was LGPL3. So this is how you can create a manifest file of the module. You can see an empty image is here. If there is an icon, if you have to give an icon for the module, what you have to do is that I will show you. You have to create a new folder inside your folder, that is create a static folder. Inside the static folder, you have to create another folder which is named description. Description. Inside this folder, you have to place the image which has to be shown here. The image which has to be shown here should be of PNG format. I have already downloaded an image. I will copy it from here, cut and paste it inside my addons path, that is Odoo12 stem OM hospital static description. I will paste it here. So I have pasted the icon image. You have to paste it inside static description. Right now it is hospital.png. It has to be renamed to icon.png. So it will come as the icon of the icon image of the module. So I have pasted and should be .png format. So I have pasted an image here. So let me go to front end and click update app list. And if I search hospital again, you can see the image get updated here. So this is how we can add an icon image for the module. So this is all about manifest file. So we will discuss rest of the things in next video, like regarding how to create a model, how to define menu, and how to define views, etc. So thank you. If you have any doubts regarding the manifest file, you can comment it out. We will reply you as soon as possible. Thank you.